Christ. The Bible says, come to me, all you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Not your wacky-backy, not your spice, not your pension, not your car, not your house, not your money, not your reputation, but He will give you peace. He will give you comfort. He will give you peace. He will give you joy. So come to His love. Come to His love. Come in. Come in. Come in to Him. And come to Christ while you can. Before one day you go home, smoke your wacky-backy, have a heart attack, and end up in hell. One day you go home, you go on holiday to Benidorm, and boom, the car crashes or the plane crashes, you end up in hell. You don't know where you'll be next week. And this is the message that can save you. This is the message that can help you. The message of Jesus and His love for you today. He cries out today. He said, James, it's all irrelevant. There's no point. Is Jesus irrelevant? Is the King of Kings irrelevant, who loved you and died for you? Is He irrelevant, who gave His life for you? Is He irrelevant, Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who loved you and died for you? Is He really irrelevant? He is altogether lovely. The fullness of God dwells in Him. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And He is not irrelevant. But when kingdoms go, when the Roman Empire went, Jesus was still here. When the British Empire went, Jesus is still here.
Amen.
When America goes, Jesus was still here.
Amen.
When your nice pair of shoes wear out, Jesus will be here. When your nice car wears out, Jesus will still be here. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who loves you and gave His life for you and saved blood. And gave His life that you may be saved today. And you say, I don't want to know. I want to go to hell, Jay. I'm happy to go to hell. I'll go to hell. I don't believe in your God. You won't last 5 minutes in hell. There's no X Factor, no iPhones, nothing in hell for you, my friend. There's nothing in hell. There's not even lottery tickets in hell. You can't get the national lottery in hell. You can't get wacky-backy in hell. You can't get spice. All you'll get in hell is Kentucky Fried Chicken. That's all you get. With the devil. You don't want that. You need Jesus, my friend. You need Jesus who can set you free. You need Jesus who loves you. Jesus who cares for you. So don't pass by tonight without dealing with your soul. You need to deal with your soul right now. Never mind paying the gas bill. Never mind paying the rent bill. Never mind about your career. What you need to do is you've got a soul. And that soul will never be happy until it rests in God. Your Savior. That's what you need your soul. You need Christ who will come in and fill you. Christ who will come in and give you joy. Say, Jay, I don't believe you. I don't believe the Bible. I can prove the Bible is the Word of God right now. Bring me the biggest, powerfulest, most educated atheist right now. Bring him here or her here. Come on. Atheist, come on. Where are you? Bring them here. PhD from Manchester University. Bring your PhD atheist right now, and I'll prove to the atheist there is a God. I'll show you there's a God. See this book, the Bible? If you don't believe that, you can't know anything. If there is no God, you don't know if your brain is being manipulated by aliens on the other side of the planet. If there is no God, you don't know if your brain is in a vat being manipulated. But if there is a God, you know reality is real and your brain is real. If there is no God, you don't know if your brain is real. So without the Bible, you can't know anything. So atheists, come on, show us that the Bible's not true. No, what we get is Bible bashing, anti-intellectual, fascist, that's all it is. Nobody can debate anymore and give rational argument. It's all, you're all this, you're phobic this, you're phobic that. You're anti this, you're anti that, but nobody can debate in a rational way. Why? Because we turn into fascists today. Well, you can't believe what you want to believe and say what you want to believe. You all have to tiptoe around and say, I can't say this, I can't say that. Well, who said that? Who said it? What mountain did some guy or woman say you can't say this or can't say that? It's all a load of nonsense. The only person who can tell you what you can say and what you can't say is God. And God gives you 10 commandments, and those commandments are love your neighbor as yourself and love God. That is relevant in every day in every society. And Jesus says, come.